As some colleges struggle to contain the spread of coronavirus, others say they have stopped outbreaks before they started. Last week, the University of Arizona said it found early warning signs of a COVID-19 outbreak by testing the sewage from its dorms. Thanks to a combination of wastewater testing, swab testing, and contact tracing, the college says it was able to prevent a potential spread among its roughly 5,000 students on campus. It is the latest example of the use of wastewater testing to catch early signs, potentially as early as a week before it would show on other types of tests. Ian Pepper is the director of the University of Arizona's Water and Energy Sustainable Technology Center, which conducted the wastewater testing. Dr. Ian Pepper, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate you coming to talk to us. Please explain how wastewater testing works and how you were able to trace it back to specific students and their location on campus.
Well, the concept of wastewater-based epidemiology is quite simple, actually. It relies on testing the wastewater from a given community for the virus, and this answers the question, is the virus in the defined community? If the answer is yes, the concentration of the virus gives an indication of the severity of the outbreak. It's an extremely sensitive test, and in fact, you can detect one infection in 10,000. There are some other critical advantages. One is that with one test, we can get an idea of the prevalence of the virus in a whole community, which in this case is a specific student dorm. Secondly, the virus concentration is a reflection of the total virus load in the community, including infected individuals with or without symptoms. And thirdly, it's a leading indicator, because when someone gets infected by the virus, they immediately start shedding the virus up to 7 days prior to visible symptoms. So this gives you seven precious days for intervention. So it's very useful for detecting the onset of a potential outbreak.
That is fascinating. And in this case, you were able to detect that there were students who had no symptoms who were positive. So that makes it even more valuable. But I'm curious about the virus you're finding in the wastewater. Is this a live virus that is infectious?
No one really knows that. No one so far has isolated infectious virus from the wastewater. We actually know from studies we did with the original SARS virus in 2009 that viruses can survive up to 3 days in wastewater, and we will be attempting to isolate live virus, but no one knows the answer to that question at this point in time.
Mm-hmm. So why exactly is wastewater testing able to find COVID-19 or detect COVID-19 earlier than the more conventional methods? Is that because it will find it in people who have no symptoms and don't know that they're infected, whereas people who go in to have a test generally have a reason to go in and test?
Well, this wastewater testing. So let me tell you the story of what happened here at the U of A last week. We tested the wastewater from multiple student dorms. One turned up positive. Immediately, the task force at the U of A was notified, including President Robbins and Rich Carmona, and the decision was made to go in and test the students in the dorm. They did that. They found the two students that were infectious. They were asymptomatic. The students were removed from the dorm and isolated. And following that, the following day, the wastewater turned up negative. So it's a very clear example of, you know, you test, you find it in the water, you then go into that defined community and test those students. So it was a very successful event last week.
Absolutely. So, Doctor, do you believe there are any major drawbacks to wastewater testing, or do you think this is something that should be more universally adopted?
I think it should be more universally adopted. We also tested wastewater treatment plants from across the country, New York, LA, Seattle, and Canada, from March through August. We did it locally here in Tucson, and the concentration of the virus correlates very closely to the number of infections on any given day. And so using wastewater-based epidemiology, we were able to see the effects of the stay-at-home in Arizona, and also the effects of opening up. So it really is an effective way to monitor the progress of the pandemic and let you know whether the pandemic is increasing, plateauing, or decreasing.
Fascinating stuff. Dr. Ian Pepper from the University of Arizona, thank you so much for telling us about your research there. Really fascinating.
My pleasure.